So the first Sigma stage, you had to fight Vile, then you had to fight Boomer Kowanger, then you had to fight a Giant Spike. This stage, the second stage, you had to fight Chill Penguin, and then Storm Eagle, and then the Phase Boss, I guess. This stage, it feels like they're building these stages, and they design, okay, we're going to have three Sigma stages, and then we're going to have the fourth final boss stage, which is going to be Sigma, right? Just like the Wily stages. Or at least somewhat like the Wily stages. So, they got to this stage, and they're like, oh fuck, the way we design other stages, we still have fucking five bosses. So, let's just cram them in really, really rapid fire, because just... We can't design two more stages. That'd be fucking crazy talk. So, I mean, look at this. I killed that guy. The room was literally right outside of the entrance. And now, I killed that guy. I go out the room, which leads right into the next boss. Yay. And then it's gonna happen again for like three more rooms. And then you get to fight the real boss. So, this fucking level has six bosses in it. I'm fucking up my rhythm. What is wrong with me? I went too fast. I'm an idiot. You don't want to go too fast, because either you mess up your rhythm, and the hit doesn't register, or he fucking falls in your head. So, that wasn't too bad. I survived. I have to preserve those boomerangs, though, because I'm going to need them to kill the final boss in this level. That'll be his weakness. And he's kind of a hard boss, so I don't want to fuck with that. Come on, man. So look at this. Just one little bitty room with like three enemies in between all these bosses. It's kind of sad, but hey, we had to do something. I remember Mega Man, you know, the other Mega Man X's, you had the three final boss stages, and then you had a boss rush. And those stages are pretty cool, but they're much longer than these, I think. At least they're much longer than the first two. This stage is by far the longest, only because you have to fight six bosses. And you get no real breaks. They do give you a couple of health tanks, but it's okay. So he's total pushover, because fucking Ice is a beast. Try to kill these guys real quick. But you can't guess which guy I gotta kill next. It's totally a mystery. There's another thing that you have to struggle with preserving your boomerangs is you have to fight, if you were keeping track, I gotta fight Launch Octopus, which as you remember, can make him way easier and way faster by chopping off his arms with boomerangs. So I gotta waste a couple on him. And then you remember that I haven't fought Flame Mammoth yet. So I'm gonna have to kill him, and you may remember you can cut off his trunk. Which, I don't know. I debate whether it's an advantage or not to cut off his trunk, because he can't shoot the oil anymore, which I guess is good, but the only thing the oil does is it's fuel for fire. So if he shoots it, then a giant fireball appears. Oh, but the fireball doesn't move or anything. Plus, every time that he's launching oil at you is another opportunity that he's not using. Another opportunity he's not taking to use fireballs or jumping on your head or something like that. So, I could do it just because it looks cool. He looks so helpless without the trunk. I mean, look, he could have shot like a bunch of fireballs at me in the time that it took him to shoot those two completely useless balls of oil, or grease, or whatever the fuck it is. It kind of looks like a giant pig without his trunk. It's Flame Pig. Or, yeah, something like that. Flame Boar, maybe? So now this boss is tricky, because he moves really fast. It's sort of like fighting Gutsman from Mega Man 1. Everything he does makes the whole screen shake, and you fall on your ass, completely helpless. And all of his attacks do a fuck ton of damage. By the way, you see those spikes that are, you know, around the brim of his face? If you let him close his face down, like if you're standing on his body and it closes down on you, instant death. Can't be avoided. But look how much damage he's doing to me with every one of these shots. I really don't want to have to use an E-Tank, but I'd rather not risk it. I don't even need it, you fucking bastard. So all his attacks fucking destroy you. He crushes you against the wall because you can't move. He can move faster than you, and he fucking freezes you in place from crashing in the walls. And that does like a third of your life. If he crushes you between his two halves, that's instant death. If he shoots you with a giant laser ball, which is virtually impossible to dodge, that does like a fourth of your life, so. Now you may know this trick, you may not. But the way they designed this is, it seems to me these enemies, these little caterpillars that are climbing out of this hole, have a much higher item spawn rate than other enemies in the game. So you pull out and charge up the shield, and you just keep hitting these guys, and you can refill all your E-tanks. So this is going to take me a minute, because I only have one E-tank full, and I'm going to charge up three. I only need three. If I can't beat Sigma in three E-tanks, then I should just kill myself, because that's pathetic. Because the thing is, like, Sigma isn't really, like, the first Sigma phase isn't hard. This is a three-stage boss, by the way. The first phase, which you fight as Dog, is easy. Second phase is easy. Unless you get hit, then he takes, like, a third of your life out. So you just have to not get hit. And then the last phase is only hard because it's so hard to dodge all the shit and hit him because his weak spot is so far out of the way. It's a pain in the ass. Similar to Mega Man X3's final boss, which is probably the most annoying of all, but you'll see that. So I refill three E-tanks, as you can see, and I'm gonna go and kill this motherfucker. Yeah, he's got a pet. Now, is it me, or is that pet? Isn't that Treble from, Mega Man series, where Bass had a sidekick dog? It looks exactly like him. I'm pretty sure, since this was made the same time as Mega Man 6, that this guy came first. So they just ripped him and put him in there. And he's actually kind of menacing. Because, I mean, he's not really all that strong, but his attacks are kind of hard to dodge, and he's got a variety of them. So like you can see, I get hit, I take hardly any damage. But when Sigma hits me, and I'm wearing armor, by the way, so that's like half of what I normally take. When Sigma hits me, I take incredible fucking damage. So you just have to not get hit. Yeah, I'm as good a hunter as you. What? You were a hunter? Say it isn't so. I will regret ever having faced you. So this is the coolest fucking theme in all of Mega Man X. It's like a badass boss theme. I'm trying to maximize my hits. This is the best weapon to use against some of the sparks. Otherwise, it's completely useless in this game. See, look at it. He even hit me with the lightsaber. The lightsaber does a fuck ton of damage. But he just hit me with his fucking face. And I took like 8 lines of damage or something. I don't know. Some crazy shit like that. If I wasn't wearing the armor, I'd almost be dead. That's how ridiculous he is. Now this may seem cheap the way I'm fighting him, but oh god, you do not want to fight him any other way. If you try to fight him on the floor, not only is he like way fucking faster than you, but he'll just come at you, hit you with a lightsaber. You'll be halfway dead. If you're not wearing the armor, you're dead. And then he uses out of his forehead, the little jewel in the middle of his forehead, he shoots sparks out of those. And they do some serious damage too. So now his head has been raptured, ascends to the heavens, and he's totally fine. So now I gotta fight this Wolverine. But look at that. Look how much fucking damage that lightning attack did. Every attack he has is really hard to dodge and does, like, at least a sixth of your life. Look at this shit. I barely survived. And I've only hit him once. Because there's, like, practically no way to get up there until one of those hands comes down and gives you a leg up. So the problem isn't really dodging or surviving, because that's okay, that's easy. But the real problem is just doing damage, because you gotta get up there and you gotta hit him right in his fucking forehead, which you can only do with two attacks. Look at this. And even there's no safe haven. Even up there, I think, okay, I'm fine. But no, the other hand comes up and punches me in the face. That's the least damaging attack that he has. Is if you get hit by those spikes. The spikes in his hand. Like, I can't climb up. They just cockblock. It is ridiculous. So, basically, I mean, the other times you fight Sigma are really hard, but if I wanted to compare this to the other times I'll fight Sigma, this is way harder. Like, if you just compared how much damage I took, it's way harder than any of the other fights I have against Sigma. Because it's just so hard to do damage without taking damage. Unless you can find some kind of crazy rhythm on the wall. But now he's been defeated by the weirdest fucking ability in the game. Why have I done this? Without the humans, my Ripplord brothers could have ushered in a new age. Which, by the way, originally I didn't know this. Like, all the robots in this game or in the series are called Reploids. And as you can see, the Sigma's castle is both exploding and sinking into the sea. So apparently it was a floating island or something. I don't know what was going on there. Some crazy, I don't even know, some crazy bullshit. But everything in the game is, all the robots are called Reploids. And then the Reploids, they get infected by the Maverick virus, or the Sigma virus, whichever you want to call it. And they get turned into Mavericks. They basically go rogue. Nothing you can do about it. And they start destroying mankind. Now the reason why they're called Reploids is because Mega Man X was the first of his kind discovered. So Dr. Kane took him and replicated him into a bunch of various forms. They basically took the... Because Dr. Kane was making robots, but he didn't know how to make robots that had, you know, empathy and intelligent thought. So he found Mega Man X, which was made by Dr. Light years ago, before he died. And X had that ability. So he replicated that ability and put it in other robots. And then eventually all these robots started going rogue and they started joining up with Sigma. He used to be the first of his kind to fight these robots. He was the first Maverick Hunter. And the first Maverick was Zero, as you probably know. And then they swapped sides for some reason. No one really... I don't know it. Maybe there's an answer. I haven't gotten to it yet. So he's fighting. He doesn't know how long his pain will last. The only answer is his gun. That's a great message for the kids, by the way. No one knows when this conflict will end, except for his gun. His gun knows where the final shot will be fired. So I think it's the first time that they're doing this thing where they show you all the names of all the enemies. But they don't show you pictures of them, so you can make an association. You gotta figure that shit out for yourself, I guess. No one knows. No one cares. I think this is kind of a thing that started copying after Super Mario World. Super Mario World did that. Wait, no. Mario Brothers 3 did that. And Super Mario World did it again. Was it in Super Mario 3 where you beat the game and they showed you the names of all of the enemies with the pictures? I don't know. I don't remember. So here's all the enemies, and now we're gonna put those fond memories montages with all the bosses or the ghosts of their AI that are now ascending to robot hell, I guess. They're all dead and they're never coming back. Fond memories. So, Mega Man's total boss. Just kind of running around. He saved the world. But the conflict will never end, because there will always be more Mavericks. He figures he could destroy Sigma, and then that would just, you know, that would end all the conflict. All the other robots would just kind of, like, so like if you killed Dracula, then all the other vampires would revert into humans or something. But, it's totally not working out that way. But maybe he's right. Maybe it does work that way. And, he just hasn't killed Sigma yet. I guess we'll find out. Oh, I'm Mega Man X. I'm fucking boss soon. Totally killed it, bro. So now we get to the real credits, where they talk about the actual people that made the fucking game that nobody cares about. And they still haven't gotten to the point where they're actually using people's names. Still using this crazy nickname bullshit. I don't even know where Inafune's name is. But here's the thing that's weird, is that Inafune, when he was developing art for this game, he developed Zero to be the protagonist, right? He was going to be the main character. And then someone else built Mega Man X, and then Zero became a secondary character. And, until Mega Man X 4, I guess, Zero has been a completely useless sidekick that no one knew anything about. But we all thought he was cool because he was red, and he was more awesome than X in every way, except for the fact that you never got to play him, and never did anything useful. Now, I love games that tell you thanks for playing at the end. I think it's a nice touch. All the Mega Man games do that, I think. Most of them do, at least. So, I think it's a nice touch. I think all games should do that. You know, give a little credit to the people that played the game long enough to fucking get to the end. I mean, nowadays, you just have to keep pushing the X button and you'll eventually win the game. But back then, games were fucking hard, so you got to the end, you had to be fucking dedicated. You had to spend all weekend on this shit. Oh no, Sigma's still alive. But is it an apparition? Or is it really his face? It was all an illusion. So he will see me very soon and totally ruin all my shit. And I will see you very soon with a new game.